Let's say you work in a theater, let's say you've been using MA2 for many years, and let's say that you sometimes need to take out an old MA2 show and run it again, and then you have to go back into MA3 and you need to start working there. The problem is that your system, your processing units and your notes is set up in MA2 mode, and if you switch to MA3, then you can't use MA2. But in this video, I'm going to show you a really, really easy way to change the mode, and you can do that through on PC or through any console. It is really easy, and let's just get right into it. As you can see, we are in MA3 mode, and if we go into network up here, you can see I have a few network consoles. I have a console, I have the on PC I'm working on here, and I have a processing unit, and I have a network node. They are all in MA3, and if you look here on my small camera, you can see everything over here, all in MA3 mode. If you want to change that, that is really simple. So let's say we want to take the console and switch that, the GrandMA3 Lite. If we go up here and we check the IP address, you can see it's 192.168.10.2. And if we go down here and we say switch to GrandMA2 software, like this, and then we need to put in the IP address. And the IP address is 192.168.10.2. So right now we are ready with the IP address, and if we push please, you can see it immediately starts to reboot into GrandMA2 mode. So let's just cancel this one out and say, okay, we want to change the entire system. In this system, we have three network units, a console and a processing unit and a network node. So we know the IP addresses, we can see them right here, but let's just say we need to do this once in a while. And just remember, when you switch mode, you do it from the GrandMA3 software. You can do it on an on-PC like I'm doing here, you can do it straight from the console, but if you want to reboot stuff into different modes, you do it from MA3, even though the network node or the processing unit might be in MA2 mode. I'll show you how it works. Oh yeah, by the way, if you are not yet signed up to EventLearning.com, you are more than welcome to head over there and check it out. We launched it last week and the support has been amazing, and there's a lot of users signed up for it already. It's free to be in there, it's free to be part of the community, and there's going to be courses. Right now we have a course on learning DMX for absolute beginners in the industry, and then of course there's going to be a GrandMA3 course, there's going to be network courses and stuff like that later on. So head over to eventlearning.com and sign up and be part of it. Let's just build a macro here. We say edit new macro line, and we say switch to GrandMA2 software again, and we say IP 192.168.10.2 like this. And see that I use camel case. Every word in the command is with a large letter. So switch is one word with a large S, two is a word with a large T, and so on. So if we say please to this, we created our first macro line. Let's just copy this one and say the next one is our processing unit is called 11. And if we copy this one, the node is called 21 in my system here. So I usually give them a second each in the macro to run. Just, I don't know why. I just like to see that it goes nice and easy. So here we have our macro. Let's just give it a new name. Switch to MA2, like this. And if we run this macro now, you will see that everything starts to change. You can see the network node is really, really fast. It takes, I don't know, 5, 6, 7 seconds. It's really fast. The console and the processing unit takes a bit longer. They need to reboot. So you can see now we are in MA2 mode. It is, I don't know how many seconds it took, but it is really, really fast. So now our entire system is in MA2 mode, and we want to go the other way. Don't think that you have to start up MA2 on PC to do this. You can do this from GrandMA3. If you go into the network settings, you can see we now have only the on PC in GrandMA3 mode, and then you have something called plugin small down here, which is our on PC network node and our processing unit. but we can still do the command to switch everything back into MA3 mode, even though they are not registered as GrandMA3 compatible devices. So if we take our macro here we just built and we say copy, and we copy it to here, we can give it a new name, and we can say this is to MA3, like this, and then we need to change the macro lines a little bit. So we take the first one and we say switch to MA3, the next one switch to MA3, and the last one switch to MA3, like this. So this is basically how simple it is. And if you look at the GrandMA2 system now, when I push this macro, it does the same thing. The console and the processing unit will ask you to confirm. If you don't confirm, it's going to do it, of course. But you can cancel it at any time during those 10 seconds. But you can see now it starts to boot up. The node is already ready in GrandMA3 mode. And in a few seconds, the processing unit and the console is going to start up in GrandMA3 mode and rejoin the session and everything like you had before. So this is how easy it is. So if you're working in a theater and you want to get started with GrandMA3, but everything is in GrandMA2 mode, this is how you do it. This is how easy it is. So I hope you enjoyed today's video. I hope you're going to give it a thumbs up. That means a lot to my channel that people like the videos. And if you're not subscribed to the channel, you're more than welcome to do so. You click the little bell icon down there and then you get a notification every time I upload a new video here on the EventLearning channel. Until I see you next time, I hope you have some happy GrandMA3 programming moments at home, and I'll see you next time in the next video. See you later. Bye-bye.